Hello everyone, my name is Tereprism, and welcome back to Stories, the Path of Destinies. Last episode we went after Iblisstone once again, but this time we went after Zenobia after we got... Well, that's a lot of afters. Anyway, we went after Zenobia trying to get corrupted, basically. And now with the choice of either sparing Zenobia or feeding her to stone. I think we're heading into dark path here and feed her to the stone. The Iblisstone, it promised great power in exchange for the blood of Zenobia. Isn't it why he came here? Killing Zenobia would give him the power to take the fight to the enemy.
With a flick of his wrist, he slashed Zenobia's throat. Her eyes widened even more. And then the light went out of them. Renardo felt amazing. Power was rushing into him like water from a burst dam.
Oh, such brilliance.
Exulted the Iblisstone. He felt a bit bad about killing her. He was pretty sure she still loved him. But needs must when the devil drives. Renardo returned to the Farfarer and set a course for the Nexus. The Empire had a communication outpost there. He could call the Emperor directly. It was time to seize the outpost and let the Emperor know what he had done.
Oh yes. We come to the dark side.
The Nexus was beautiful. He never realized how beautiful. Everything glowed. The wind was so sweet. The sun so soft. The stones so warm. Black raven feathers.
So black tasty. Feathers.
Suddenly, his eyes are filled with them. He's falling through smoke under a dead sun. A voice calls him home.
Is this a vision?
Is this the time of the lost gods? Or the future? No matter.
I guess
what
it's mattered bold.
Now was killing his way to the Imperial outpost and challenging the Emperor from there. This chest had teaspoons stolen from every inn in Boreas. Oh, and something more useful.
And let's go this side path here. Anything nice over here? Quite empty so far. There's plenty of time spent traveling between points here.
Asked when
oh, come on!
Back. No, I'm dying! They both laughed hysterically.
Oh, you're not going to be laughing with that joke. There's that chest. Just the energy. And this way, apparently.
Up ahead was Lupino.
Oh.
What was he doing here?
Yeah, I like to know that too.
Renardo! Hey, buddy!
buddy. Hey there, old buddy. Please don't kill me.
Why would I kill you?
Asked Renardo, although he had been thinking about it.
Well, you've become... No. I mean, no disrespect at all here. Kind of evil? Maybe you should, I don't know, go to the mountains to have a think. See if maybe you're sure the stone is not all that healthy a thing to keep.
I suppose you want it, Renardo said, and poked Lupino in the chest for emphasis. Oh, had he just killed Lupino?
It?
Damn it.
I didn't really want to do that. Yeah. That happened. I really didn't want to kill Lupino.
This is quite the view, he thought.
There was not even a choice there. I kind of wish there would have been. That went easily.
Renardo rampaged through the Imperial outpost like a buffalo rampaging. At the last moment, he remembered not to kill the Far Speaker Toad. After all, he wanted a word with the Emperor. But there was only silence. The Emperor was scared, like little girl. Well, he would gather the rebel army and slaughter the Imperial fleet. Applauded the Imblestone. Tremendous. Then the Emperor would have to answer his Far Speaker, wouldn't he? Who are you? Asked a distant voice that sounded uncomfortably like Zenobia. What have you become? The mountains. Go to the mountains, urged another that sounded a bit like Lupino.
Which one I want to take? Yeah, I think Reynardo, even if he is turning a little bit evil, would listen to his friends. That's what I've been getting of Reynardo so far. Listen to the distant voices. Reynardo has become an amazing warrior, all thanks to the Imblestone. But then there were these distant voices. Maybe he should listen to the voices and go to the mountains. Oh yes.
What are you doing? Demanded the Imblestone. I need to think, Reynardo told it.
You're not good at thinking,
said the Imblestone.
You're good at killing.
Oh, be quiet.
But he set sail for the mountains, where he could be alone with his thoughts. Why were there Raven Scouts here in the empty mountains? Was there nowhere he could find peace and quiet? There were other Ravens here too, shadowy ones. Transparent, lining the path.
Oh.
Ghosts. They cawed as he passed, but they didn't try to stop him. Spectators. Had he really killed that many ravens?
Yeah, I was about to say, I guess they're those ravens he just killed. Nothing there. At least nothing apparent there. Even more ravens. Oh, no you don't.
I think this is yours.
San Bernardo. But he couldn't hear his enemy's answer.
That went easily, even though I got hit.
Then he saw her. Zenobia. She was a ghost, too. She ran off when she saw him. How could a ghost be afraid? He followed her. He had to.
Let's solve this mystery here. Down here, I think. And let's open this doorway. All the way down. Even more ravens. Yeah, this is getting kind of spooky already. Not in bad way spooky, but still. Oh, come on. That was a bit tricky. And that chest is open. Halfway there to make that next sword. Even more ores.
There were stickers all over the platform for really hot lady boxes with pictures and addresses and everything.
I thought you were after Zenobia and not the other boxes. Come on, let me through.
Bernardo followed Zenobia's ghost. Had he gone mad, seeing ghosts? Was she running from him or leading him somewhere?
He'd come here
to be alone, but he'd never been less alone in his life. Every raven he'd slain haunted these rocks. Was this who he was? A killer. He was terribly good at killing. Adventure. Or is that just another word for killer?
You kill.
Whispered the stone.
It is what you are masters of. Embrace this destiny.
Maybe not. Come on.
Bernardo had been to a dungeon once, where all the chests had teeth and eyes.
Maybe short chests. Any... Even more ravens! And not dead ones, eh? Anything over here. Just a route upwards. We should be reaching top soon. And we can finally figure out where... Why is Zenobia leading us? Just going to go quickly through this instead of checking that side path there. Although this one I have to open up.
Sometimes, Bernardo really tried to focus on the job he had to do. The rebellion. Wasn't there a battle coming soon?
Oh yes, there
even
is.
Reasons to kill. Even an emperor. Such killing. Much wow. Ooh, he'd never been so excited.
let's level up quickly before heading forward. And let's get this fully leveled up. And now for the truth.
At the end of the mountain path, Zenobia awaited him. He could see right through her.
Why did you kill me? She said. I was your prisoner, and I loved you.
I needed the power, he said. Haven't you heard? There's a war on.
And you were an enemy.
What's your excuse for killing me? Asked his old friend Lupino.
Accident?
Stepping out of the shadows. Renata didn't have an answer for that.
The demon has twisted you, said Zenobia. Abandon the stone. You've lost too much already.
Her words bit deeper than any sword ever had. So he shook his head, and once again swung his blade through her and Lupino. It had to mean something. If he gave up the stone now, he would have sacrificed Zenobia and Lupino for nothing. So,
Renato set course
for the Imperial fleet, where he would end it all. The Emperor, the war, the madness.
Not sure if I like that choice there. Oh well, let's just see where this leads.
Renato boarded an Imperial ship. No one could stop him slashing his way towards the Emperor. Yes, that was right. To give up now would be to lose everything for nothing. But if he could liberate the land from the Mad Emperor, then he could give up the stone in peace. And those were absolutely his own thoughts. Not the stone manipulating him, right?
Maybe a little bit.
Yes! Exulted the stone.
Oh, be silent.
He could hear a tiny voice within him. Don't kill the Emperor. Stone will eat your soul. Madness. I have to kill the Emperor. He told himself. That's what it meant to be a hero. To do what had to be done, no matter how terrible the cost.
Not really.
Promise the stone.
You can be a hero without killing evil guy. It might not be always best choice, but
take the goat across first.
Almost there. Let's get these down first, and then plenty of ravens to deal with. Oh! There was twice two attacks simultaneously. So far I'm really enjoying this game. There we go! Feel that, and
the tiny voice, whatever it was silent. He couldn't see ghosts around him, but he could feel them. If he gave up, they would be angry. They would have all died for nothing.
Not
Who
really.
Give up this kind of power? Could anyone? Well, he was just a fox with a talent for swordplay. How had this burden come to him? The Emperor offered the sword.
Strains are bad ways.
Peace.
I'm not even sure what I was trying to say there. And you can have peace without falling for that. I know I wanted to see him being corrupted, but I'm starting to get second thoughts about this. But I'm already committed to this storyline, so let's see it through. Oh, it's been a while since last time we went this way.
He'd confront the Emperor. Funny that this whole war had come about because the Emperor feared death. Now it was coming for him. There was some sort of lesson there, wasn't there?
Maybe a little bit. Plenty of enemies here. And here's our way inside. I wonder, will we finally confront Emperor, or is this once again a mistaken pathway? I guess it will be mistaken that way.
The Emperor was cowering in front of his ship.
Please don't kill me,
croaked Emperor Isengrim III.
Here, take the crown. I don't want it anymore.
You must kill him while you're at his troops. You must send assassins.
Please, have mercy. The rebellion is one. Or you could be emperor. I'll just go be a scientist. Or minstrel. So gummy bears. Yeah, I promise not to bother you.
He's definitely afraid.
Mr. Moment.
With all the love he'd ever had for Zenobia, for Lupino, for the kit foxes he would never have, Renardo raised his sword.
Stop.
And Renardo plunged his sword
into his own
chest.
Well, that kind of... That was completely unexpected.
As his life force ebbed into the stone and surged back into him, and ebbed out and surged back in. Screamed the stone. It began to heat up. What have you done?
Well, I have to say, this is correct choice after all,
it became lava.
Unexpected one.
Nice knowing you, said Renardo, as the lava ran like butter. And he died. He should go back to some of the choices he'd faced before. Maybe there were new paths that had opened up. Like those doors he was opening up all over the map that took him to new treasures and around his enemies. And he hadn't learned anything new this time. He'd done the same thing twice, yet expected a different outcome.
New story completed. Story number 13. Voices. What kind of hero are you? A hero who does what needs to be done, no matter the cost. Yeah, that hero description is same as one of the previous storylines, but we unlocked a new storyline. Yeah. And I discovered this today. I just don't know why I took so long to find this. But I think this is a good place to end this episode. Thanks everyone for watching. I will see you next time. I hope you enjoyed this one. Goodbye!